Welcome to this video, Open Science Framework, also known as OSF, and how to register a protocol. So let's go ahead and get started. All right. To get to OSF, you can type in osf.io, or if you don't remember that, you can also type in Open Science Framework in your Google browser, and it will come up. So you can get to it either way. If you have not done so already, I do advise that you have to create an account before you can register a protocol with OSF. So all you have to do is hit sign up. It is a free account, so that is easy to do. I am going to go ahead and hit sign in since I've already done so. You can also link your OSF to your ARGIT ID. If you did it while you were doing setup, great. If not, you can always link it later. I'm going to go ahead and hit sign in. When you sign in, you will always come to your dashboard of your projects, or if you were invited to a registration of a protocol, you can also see them down below. So what we're going to do is you can one, go to My Projects and create a new project, or from your dashboard, you can hit Create New Project. So I'm going to go ahead and hit Create Project. You will put your title in. This title can be the name of your title of your project, whatever you can want to put in there. That's what you're going to name it as. We're going to stick with the United States, and then we're going to go ahead and hit create. It will give you a message saying it was created successfully. From there, we're going to go ahead and hit go to project. Once we get in here, this is kind of just a template background information here. What we're going to be focusing on is this section right here where it says registration. So we're going to go ahead and click on that. From there, it basically takes you into this new dashboard. So this is what you'll see when you are working throughout your project. When you click on your project from your dashboard, you'll see draft registrations and you'll see your actual registration once you do get it registered. To get to a draft registration, first we need to do a new registration. So they do have multiple different ones here to select. I always recommend going to the generalized symptomatic review registration. Even if you are doing a scoping review, this is perfectly fine. Those sections that talk about symptomatic reviews, you can just put NA, not applicable to this review because you are working on a scoping review. But I do recommend that you use this one. And then we're just gonna hit create draft. So what this will do now is it will start taking you through the whole process of a scoping review or symptomatic review protocol. So right here, where is our title? You can come back in here and change this anytime you need to. Here, this is basically your description of your project. Down here, you can add collaborators. So you can add people to your project here. You could just hit this plus sign. And then you could search for their name. If they're in here, it will automatically have their email. If not, you can hit add by email. So this will send your collaborators an email from there. Licenses, you just pick which one. I usually go with the you'll have to pick which one that best fits your project. Most of the time you don't have a license, so you can also hit no. From there, you will come down and do your sections of your subject. So you can specifically state which subject. If you click this down arrow, you can get into more detailed. You can also do your search subjects. If you're not sure what category it's under, you can also do the search of a subject. From there, you can also do tags. So however you want to tag your project, if there's something specific, you can definitely tag it from there. It could also be other subject terms that may not be up above that you can tag it with. So this is your basically your metadata of your project. So when people come into OSF and do that search, this is what will be coming up. So that's something that you want to think about when you are doing your subjects and also your tags and how you want your project to be recognized. Going through the next steps is your landing page. This is just general information in regards to this template. Moving down to the next one is the review methods. So you can It does give detailed information in here in regards to it. So like if this one is a scoping review, you would put your detailed paragraph information or a couple sentences in regards to your type of review. And then you'll just kind of start going through and answering all of these questions. Software always does come up. Software that you can be including in this section would be like Covidence. It could be EndNote, Zotero, whatever citation manager that you're using. This could be any data visualization if you are using anything in that sorts. So that's what software would be. Funding, this is if you are getting funding from like NIH or any type of grants within the university or outside of the university. Conflict of interest, if there is any. Most of the time, there will not be. And then overlap. So that's pretty much your review method section. Search strategy is here. It just walks you through what databases you're using. Inferences, this is what platform it houses on. So, for example, if you are using CINAHL, you want to put your platform of EBSCO because that's the platform it sits on. If you are not sure which platform that your databases sit on, feel free to reach out to your library liaison to guide you. If you're not sure what databases or gray literature to use, reach out to your library liaison and they can provide assistance. And then this just talks about more of your search strategy and your search methods. Again, if you need help with this section in building a search string or search strategy, identifying databases, feel free to reach out to your library liaison and we can guide you through that. The next section down is your screening section. This is just your phases of screening to do blinding so that way there is no bias in your project. Most of the time, a lot of people use Covidence and do two reviewers through this. Sometimes they have more than two reviewers, but that's pretty much what the screening process will be. Round one screening would be your title, full text, and abstract screening. Your second screening would be your full text and then your data extraction. So those will be your two screening platforms. You're going to put your inclusion criteria again here, same one that you can copy over. This is a section where you can upload documents like your appendix A and Bs if they are available. So that's what this section is more about, is all your screening information. The next section down is your extraction section. This just goes through that last section of your project, which is your extraction of tables. So this is where you can actually upload your template of tables that you will be building in Covidence. That's a platform you are using. And it just kind of walks you through the rest of these areas. Like data management, you can put this one if you're doing a scoping review as non-applicable because you don't need anything to do with data management. This next section is more pertained to a scope systematic review, not a scoping review. So most of this data, like the data visualization, you don't necessarily need to put in there because you put not applicable. Or if you want, you can even put Excel in here because you may, even for a scoping review, you might want to do some nice charts in regards to the data that you did gather. The quality assessment and the synthesis plan, most of the time for scoping reviews, you do not need these ones. This is more pertained to a systematic review. So that's kind of the direction. If you have any questions, like I said previously, feel free to reach out to me, but most of this section is going to be more pertained to a systematic review than a scoping review. For a scoping review, the only ones that will really apply is this first two boxes. And then the third one, if you are deciding to put any type of charts or graphs in your platform. And then from there, you will have this nice little layout review of all of your information. As you can see, mine says blank because I didn't fill in the document. But this is a nice way to kind of review each section to see if you need to make any edits. Once you do that, you can hit register and then it will go to COVID or to OSF team and they will register it. Usually it's done within 48 hours, so it's a very good quick turnaround to do this. Something else to keep in mind that when you are working in OSF on these templates, only one person can be making edits at a time. So you can either assign different sections to people in your team and different days that you guys are going to work on it, or you guys can all come in here on a Zoom meeting and kind of crank it out from there. We as librarians also do have the template. So if you wanted a copy of the template and work in a Word document first, and then you can assign sections, and then all you have to do is copy and paste it over. If you have any other questions in regards to OSF and getting your protocol registered, please feel free to reach out to us library liaisons, and we will be happy to guide you along the way.